Good morning, everybody. and welcome to the Technology Transition Workshop sponsored by the National Institute of Justice and being held here at NFSTC. We're very happy to be here. My name is Jose Almiral. I'll be one of your instructors, and this is Patty Diaz Guerra, who will be the other instructor. And this workshop is entitled, and you don't have it up on the screen here, Field Detection of Drug and Explosive Odor Signatures Using Planar Solid Phase Microextraction Ion Mobility Spectrometry. That's a long name. But basically what we're wanting to do is to give you an additional tool for your job in detecting drugs and explosives. And so we'll go through a series of exercises, lectures, theories, and hopefully we'll convince you by the end of the day on Wednesday that what we call PSBMI, planar solid phase microextraction, is an additional tool that you could use. So I'll give you a little bit of history of this technology, and we'll have a lot of chance to discuss how it works and in both theory and practice. But first, I want to introduce myself, Jose Almiral. I'm a chemistry professor at Florida International University, also the director of the International Forensic Research Institute down at FIU, and also a practicing, a chemist. In my prior life, I used to work for a police department. I worked for 12 years for the Miami-Dade Police Department as a forensic chemist. And about 13 years ago, I made a move to the university, where I'm now teaching and conducting research in forensic chemistry, hopefully developing tools that will be useful to practitioners like yourselves to do your work.
I'm Patricia Guerra-Diaz, and I graduated from Dr. Almiral's lab with my PhD in chemistry. And my dissertation project was based on the work that you'll see us outline throughout this workshop, and you'll be practicing with the PSBMI device on the laboratory exercises. I'm currently employed by Field Forensics, Inc., and I'm a development scientist with that company. And we sell explosives detection kits and supplies for first responders. I also have a background in fire debris analysis. I did my undergraduate research with Dr. Almiral in that field, and I'm very happy to be here with you today.
Okay, so in a couple of minutes, we'll get the chance to introduce each other. I would like for all of you to introduce yourselves as well. I'd just like to have an outline of the workshop. And you heard from Carrie, who, by the way, even though she says she's not an instructor, has kept us on task here. And was extremely helpful in all the work leading up to this workshop. So thank you, Carrie, for all the hard work. It took quite a bit of work to get all the lectures in order, get all the laboratory exercises in order, and Patty was instrumental in that. But so were some of my students who came here and did a dry run a couple of weeks ago. But thanks to the NFSTC staff, Carrie, my students, and Patty, for all the hard work to get this prepared. We've done the introduction of the instructors, I've talked a little bit about the aims of the workshop is to introduce to you what I would say is a new tool, and I'll tell you why it's new in a couple of in the next presentation. So here are the aims: is to utilize this new planar SPMI device for sampling air for subsequent detection of explosives. We're going to use the PSBMI matrix. It's a relatively simple tool for both sampling air but also for collecting particles. We're going to become familiar with drug and explosive detection, and I'm going to ask each of you to tell me how familiar you are with some of these ETDs right now. How much do you use them in your jobs? And we're actually going to do some demonstrations, exercises, and then unknowns. You're actually going to we're going to have some hides, and you're going to find the explosives when we hide them. So the format is lectures, demonstrations, where the instructors will actually be showing you what to do in terms of the hands-on stuff. And then in the facilitated exercises, you will be doing the hands-on stuff. And then we're going to let you cut you loose and have you do the hides, have you do the findings. So this is what I'd like for you to do. I'll leave this up on the screen. And I'm going to go around the room, around the table here. And I want each of you to describe your current job responsibilities related to either drug or explosive detection. List the technologies that you currently use, any ETD systems that you currently use, including ion mobility spectrometry. We're interested in particular if you have any experience with IMS. And if you like, you can describe a recent interesting case in which you use an ETD in your capacity. And then just let us know, you know, why you're here. What would you like to get out of this workshop? And that will help us as we instruct you for the rest of the week. So, Brian, do you want to begin?
Sure. My name is Brian Cook. I'm with the Fairfax County Police Department in Virginia. I've been with the department for 21 years now. Currently, I'm a bomb tech with the department. I've been a bomb tech since 2002. As part of that function, I'm a canine handler. I have a Labrador from the ATF, which I've had for approximately 6 years now. One of the things that we're interested in is the vapor detection. I have a supervisor currently that's interested in the vapor detection dog. One of the things that we're looking at is comparing the latest equipment out there with the capabilities of the dog, basically just which one's the better tool to have. They're not really looking to get another dog, they're looking for advancement in that area. So this is one of the things that I was sent here for, is not only will I receive the training, but something that I can bring back to them and show them that, hey, either this is the way that we need to go or head off in a different direction. As far as any cases, I mean, a lot of what we do and detection work would be with the hazmat unit. We work well with the hazmat unit, which is rare for most police departments to work with the fire department. However, we do. Out of all of the entities, we work best with them. What our latest and I guess greatest would be to utilize robots with the equipment strapped to the robot and be able to feed that information back electronically to keep people out of harm's way. That's been our focus lately. As far as other technologies, I mean, the True Defender, things like that, different types of four gases, but nothing as far as actual explosives to actually go in and do a swipe and try to locate it that way.
Great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Jimmy?
My name is Jimmy Giraldo. I work for the Boston Police Department. I'm assigned to the crime scene unit right now. We've just recently been told that we're moving into processing crime scenes that have biohazmat and biochemical stuff in it. So we're all still new to this stuff. We're trying to see what technologies out there that we could actually use to keep us safe. So this, we figure this might actually apply to us and maybe it's a tool we can use. Right now they've planned for us to go in and process the crime scene, but they haven't planned like what we do before we enter a crime scene. So we have all sorts of gear to get in, but nothing to tell us not to go in. So we figured this would be something good to learn about, to see if it's something that we can use. I have no experience in any of this stuff, never used any equipment, so I'm brand spanking new to this whole thing.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Caroline Hamby. I work for the Florida Department of Environmental Protection with the Division of Law Enforcement, Bureau of Emergency Response. I'm currently the statewide coordinator for forensics for the state. There's normally two of us. There's only one of me right now. Hired anybody else yet. I currently do all hazmat, chemical related forensics, like anything that's left on scene that we don't know what it is. As far as explosives, I'm normally on scene after it already exploded. So, and drugs, just meth lab, so I don't really have much on that. And of course, just learning anything new, any new technology, keeping up to date.
Great, thanks.
My name is Robert Kalin, Louisville Metro Police Department. As far as experience, I think I've been to an Ahura workshop a couple years ago. But other than that, that's the only thing we've had.
Okay. FIU was just up there playing Louisville last week.
Yeah, I know. Wasn't very good for us.
Sorry about that. Adam?
Adam Miller, Director of Emergency Management for Huntingdon County. Have a couple of part-time interfacing responsibilities with this. I do have done some research supporting the U.S. Army in laser-induced breakdown spectroscopy detection for explosives and other suburban items of interest. And I'm a part-time police officer as well still, so I will be hopeful to use this technology someday on the street myself.
Okay, thank you. Ryan.
With the Louisville Metro Police Department Bomb Squad. I've been a bomb tech with the police department for about 10 years. I'm also an explosive ordnance disposal technician in the Air Force Reserves, been active and in the reserves for 19 years. On the bomb squad, we currently don't have a lot of this technology. In the military, we have some of the first offenders we use overseas, trying to see if there's a better or more applicable product for use on the police department, but also in deployed environments.
Okay, thank you.
How you doing? Tom Sharkey, I'm a sergeant with the Metro Transit Police in Washington, D.C. I've been on 22 years, been the bomb squad commander for the last 12. We've experimented with a lot of the technologies, Sabre 4000, FIDO, Ahors. We do a lot of bag checks, screening of sort of passengers, people. Looking for new technologies to try to harden the softer target, I should say, to screen these people effectively but quickly, you know, unlike an airport. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty much where we're trying to go.
Okay, thank you. Richard?
I'm Rich Mata. I'm with the Department of Defense. I'm out of Cocoa Beach. I work in an applied research and development division up there. So a lot of our responsibilities are testing and evaluation of equipment, explosives detection equipment, equipment for detecting other toxics. We will typically advise people who go out in the field, who go out in the field all over the world, on what equipment to use, and basically endorse it through validation testing. So that's primarily my job responsibility. We use a lot of the IHRA devices. We use colorimetric screening tools like the field forensics kits and others. And as far as what I'd like to get out of this, I'm working under Dr. Elmore right now. So I'll be doing master's work, working for him. So this will be one of the instruments that I look at in that work.
Okay, great. So before we get started with the first lecture, does anybody have any questions as to the format, the content, for the rest of it? Well, I would, okay, that's a great question. Thank you. We would like some feedback because this project was funded by NIJ as a research project. And so we had this idea to basically mimic what the dogs do. So explosive detection right now is primarily done in the particle. You know, when you go to the airport and you say you want to, you know, do screen people like they do in the airport, they are looking at, you know, removing particles from surfaces and then doing the analysis with these ETDs. Okay, that's primarily the way to do it. Now there are instruments where they are sniffing. What we wanted to do is to improve the possibility of detecting vapor signatures. So there's a couple of things we're doing differently. One is targeting compounds that are not necessarily the explosives themselves. And the other is picking up the volatiles. So right now, the instruments are set up and calibrated to detect the explosives. Well, we're going to try to detect other things that are associated with the presence of explosives. And that's exactly what the dogs do. And that's because the volatile components are available to be detected. So that's the first thing. The second thing is we're going to pre-concentrate that. We're going to take some chemistry. We're going to use some chemistry to collect and pre-concentrate onto a surface all the odors so that they can be then detected by an instrument. What we'd like from you is feedback, because this went from laboratory, research laboratory, to commercialization. Now, there is a company that makes this device right here across the street, actually. It's Field Forensics is commercializing it. And now we'd like to get it out in the field. And this is what NIJ is interested in, is to transition technology from the research laboratory out to the field. And that's exactly what this is. So what we'd like from you, and be totally honest, you know, tell us, you know what, this is just not going to work this way. You have to come up with this other mechanism for whatever reason. And that's why I'd like to, that's why you're here, is to give us this feedback. And that's extremely useful. Anything else? So Pat's representative of the company who's commercializing, so she's also listening to, and you have a direct pipeline to the people who can make improvements in this in a commercial product. We do have a lot of time built in between the lectures. So even during the lectures, if you have any questions, comments, please feel free. Let's make this, you know, fairly informal. Don't be intimidated by all the lights and the microphones. Let's make it informal. And if you have any questions at any time, just, you know, raise your hand, and or don't even raise your hand. Just, you know, refer to me by Jose, and let me know what's on your mind, okay?